Guys, I think I just got a message from Shelby, guys. So, please, please say Trenton jump. Please. As the waves crashed against the rough rug cliffs. Guys, this is melodrama, and this is what could happen if someone doesn't stop someone. If you are seeing anyone in this position, please help them. Try and get them support. As the waves crashed against the rug cliffs, Shelby stood there. Tears streaming down her face, and her heart aching with fear and desperation. She couldn't believe the sight before her, Trenton tethering on the edge, as if life itself had lost all meaning. With every ounce of strength and love in her, she called out to him, "Trenton, please, don't do this. I'm so sorry, Trenton. I'm sorry that Harold took advantage of you, that you lost baby Andrew in that painful custody battle, and that your marriage with Kyra ended. But please, don't jump." Trenton turned to Shelby, his eyes still carrying the weight of... I'm so sorry. Like, what is this? Like, oh my goodness. Trenton turned to face Shelby, his eyes still carrying the weight of despair. The wind seemed to whisper its own desperate plea, urging him away from the abyss. Shelby continued, her voice trembling with emotion. "You mean so much to me, to Andrew, and all those who care about you. You're not alone in this, Trenton. You don't have to carry this pain by yourself. We can help you, but you have to choose to let us in." Tears welled up in Trenton's eyes as he listened to Shelby's heartfelt words. It was like a lifeline in the stormy sea of despair. Slowly, he stepped back from the edge, his shoulders slumming as if he'd let go of a heavy burden. "I'm sorry," he whispered. His voice choked with emotion. He took trembling steps towards Shelby, and she rushed to him, wrapping her arms around him in a tight embrace. For a moment, they clung to each other, two souls connected by a profound pain. They'd shared. "I'll get help," Trenton said, his voice determined. "I can't keep going like this. I need to find a way out of this darkness." Shelby held him even closer, tears of relief now mixing with their shared sorrow. "We'll find a way, Trenton. You're not alone in this journey. We'll get through it together." In the days that followed, Trenton took the first step towards healing. He sought professional help to address the deep emotional wounds he'd been carrying. It wasn't an easy journey, and there were setbacks along the way, but he was no longer alone in his struggle. With Shelby's unwavering support and the help of therapists and support groups, Trenton slowly began to rebuild his life. He mended his broken relationships with those who cared about him. Trenton's path towards healing was far from linear, but he had hope now, something he hadn't felt in a long time. And as he walked it, he knew that Shelby would be there beside him every step of the way. The story of Trenton's darkness and despair has now taken a new turn. One that held the promise of redemption and renewal. It was a reminder that even in the darkest of times, with love, support, and determination, it is possible to find a way back to the light. Thank you so much, guys, for watching Trenton's story. If you need support, there will be a support in the description for Trenton's story, if you have been affected by Trenton's story. Goodbye.